Terrific quarter, terrific growth. Obviously, you've been a big benefactor of this switch to telehealth over the last year, the acceleration of it. But one of the things that I think investors are trying to sort out is your guidance. On the one hand, you say that you have a great opportunity now with the integration of Livongo to do more cross-selling to employers. They want a complete package with management of chronic conditions. You ended the year with 51.8 million paid members, but you're only forecasting 52 to 54 million for 2021. That seems like really small growth given the opportunity.
We are here at mid-year financial checkup for Teladoc. They've announced they will release Q2 2021 results today, July 27th, for the period ending June 2021. Teladoc stock price, like many growth stocks since February of this year, have seen significant drops in stock price. Teladoc stock price is down nearly 50% from its peak this year. Welcome to MGA Investing. My name is Dee. To put that recent volatility into context, you also have to understand those ups and downs are not always a reflection of reality. A stock going up doesn't always mean value, nor does one going down necessarily mean a good deal. The thing you have to remember when investing is, what did you get in it for? What did you like about the company? And are they still moving forward on the promises that ignited your excitement about the company? Has anything materially changed about maybe the way that they do business? Have they veered off of their stated business plan? Did you buy the stock for one day, one month, one year, or even 3 to 5 years? I personally like a 3 to 5 year range, but I'm also, as I mentioned before, I'm very focused on return targets of 15 to 20%. And when the stock hits those targets, regardless of where I am in the ownership cycle, I'm known to milk that cow a little to take, you know, some cream off the top to preserve some of that return, especially in an overheated and overbought market. You know, I want to preserve some of those returns. My expectation is that revenue should be up for Q2, and if they miss expected EPS at all, it won't be material enough to shake my tree. Business demands for their services should have adjusted downward slightly as the pandemic started to come at least a little bit under control. Q4 2020 and Q1 2021. We can also expect that with the pandemic back on the rise in the U.S. for unvaccinated people, which account for 99.9% of the COVID-19 hospitalizations and deaths in the U.S., that some of the hospital protocols that we've experienced at least in the past during the first half of the pandemic will be back in effect, which bodes well for Teladoc services and the demand for their actual services. It's been predicted that COVID-19 related hospitalization and deaths should peak about October of this year, getting us well into Q3 and possibly Q4. Despite what some analysts are saying, don't buy into the notion that Teladoc is a stay-at-home stock. If anything, the pandemic helped usher in what needed to happen in terms of telehealth services anyway. But reluctant, entrenched owners of that legacy archaic health system refused to change, although the market demanded it with an aging population. Now, did the stock get overheated, overcrowded, and overtraded during the height of the pandemic? I will agree with you, absolutely. But telehealth and Teladoc are here to stay. Look, I think there's going to be some unpredictable EPS estimates and revenue estimates in the coming quarters for the fact of the uncertainty of the pandemic and how it impacts the demand for Teladoc services, and also the fact that it has to continue to grow into their shoes a bit financially. I mean, imagine over the last several years, at least to build their economies of scale, they made some big acquisitions. Livongo, the largest of those acquisitions, though strategically necessary, came at a great cost. Let's take a look at some other estimates as they've been reported pre-Q2 results call. Seeking Alpha reported the consensus EPS estimate is about negative 54 cents, and the consensus revenue estimate just a little over 499 million. And 107.4% year-over-year increase in revenue. Now, I'm not going to disagree much with that revenue estimate. Last year's sales same period was just over 241 million. Teladoc has been earning estimates 100% of the time over the last 2 years. Zacks Investment Research, which is based on 10 analysts' forecasts, the consensus EPS forecast for the quarter at about negative 59 cents per share. Reported EPS for the same quarter last year, again, was about 34 cents per share. Bazinga Insight is estimating a Teladoc EPS loss of around negative 56 cents a share, according to sell-side analysts. Sales will likely be near 500 million. So we're seeing estimates from negative 54 to negative 59 cents. Let's split the difference and call it negative 56 and a half. What does it mean if they fall somewhere in those ranges? Well, materially to me, not much. Over the last 2 years, Teladoc has hit EPS estimates 75% of the time. I would expect Q2 results to be consistent with their past performance in terms of EPS estimates. Adjusted EBITDA estimate of $63.3 million. Over the last 3 months, EPS estimates have seen 2 upward revisions and 9 downward revisions. Over the last 3 months, EPS estimates have seen 2 upward revisions and 9 downward. As you can see. We can see in this earnings per share chart here, the estimated earnings per share, that's Q2 2020, negative 23 cents a share. Reported earnings per share was a negative 34 cents a share. And we go to Q3 2020, estimated was 33 cents a share. Reported earnings per share, they came in at negative 13 cents a share. A little bit better there. So estimated earnings per share, negative 25 cents a share. Reported earnings per share, a negative 27 cents a share. That was fourth quarter 2020. And then we get into Q1 of 2021, the estimated a negative 57 cents a share. They came in at a positive 13 cents a share. And then this is where we are right now, waiting for that report to come out at the bell ring later today. And so that estimate, again, showing, you know, a negative 59 cents a share, and we know we can be anywhere between that 54 cents to 59 cents a share mark. Revenue, on the other hand, have seen 21 upward revisions and 2 downward, demonstrating the difficulty in the financial climate to forecast. The Teladoc numbers I'm most focused on, as I've mentioned throughout my 5-video Teladoc comprehensive stock analysis, is the quarterly revenue per member growth, which was $2.25 per member versus 87 cents just a year ago. As we all anticipate Teladoc's Q2 results call, the question remains, is Teladoc overvalued or undervalued at this time as the stock price floats around the $140 per share range going into today's call? My take, if you follow my Teladoc stock analysis on the MGA Investing channel, specifically the video, is Teladoc undervalued, is that $147, well, it's clearly undervalued. More recently, Seeking Alpha contributor Seeking Value Research made the case that they thought the company's stock is undervalued and called it a great long-term success opportunity for investors. Now, analysts from Piper Sandler and Cohen and Company, more recently, Seeking Alpha contributor Seeking Value Research made the case that they thought that the company's stock is, well, undervalued and called it a great long-term success opportunity for investors. Analysts from Piper Sandler and Cohen and Company, their analysts, well, they squashed the concerns that Teladoc could be negatively impacted by Amazon's possible entry into the telehealth field beyond their own employees' needs. And if you've seen more recent news, Teladoc announced it's teaming up with Microsoft to create a unified practice experience for clinicians using the tech giant's Teams platform. I'll be tuning into the call just like many of you will today. And once I process what's been said, I'll report back to you what my thoughts were on the call, what surprises, if any, and what I might see on the horizon in terms of their performance of the company in the coming quarters. Thanks for watching. If you found value in the information provided in this video, well, hit the like button and please subscribe so you can be the first to catch my recap of Teladoc's Q2 report call. There's no place on YouTube that will give you more in-depth stock analysis of Teladoc. You may not always agree with me, but you can be guaranteed I'll give you a lot to think about. We'll see you on the next video.